We are live, and it's Sunday. So what does every Sunday bring about for us? A new week, a new opportunity. So I've been coming to you guys for the past week, every day, with my fitness pieces. And along with that fitness piece has been my mindset piece. And this is all in conjunction with the hashtag Little Black Dress 90 Day Challenge, which you still have the ability to join. That challenge is an ongoing challenge that allows you to plug in, and as you plug in, that's when your 90 days starts. And as I explain to you how that challenge goes about, there is a component where you are buying a little black dress. But to hear more about that, we'll talk on a side note, actually one-on-one. But when I come to you guys on a daily for this month, it's specifically talking about getting into action, because I've committed to coming to the gym every day and working out for the entire month of October. And so one of the things that I had told myself that I wanted to do for this month of October was to not have any fries. That's one of my favorite foods, guys. And my reason for letting go fries wasn't necessarily for the health component or any of those things. It was more of my attachment to them and how I would just have them at will and not have any, I would say sometimes, control over when I was or wasn't having them. So that was my reasoning for doing it. It was more mindset and being more conscious of my choices. And so the hashtag for today, or the mindset piece for today, is yikes, I ate fries. I had fries today, guys. And when I ate them, I started to feel really bad. And I said, why am I beating myself up for something like this? The challenge is not meant to ever make you feel bad. My instructions, my guidance, my accountability when I'm working with people is never to leave them feeling bad. I'm always coming from a place of empowerment. So if I'm feeling bad for doing something that I wanted to do, then I need to ask myself, why was I really doing it? Was I doing it for me, or was I doing it for show? Was I doing it to say, oh, I can do this for 30 days? And I feel like that's more where I was coming from, because the way I was beating myself up and the guilt that I had around it. And just like how I talk to my clients and I tell them, you know what? If you do something that you didn't have intentions of doing and it didn't service you, then what are you going to do the next day? How are you going to behave moving forward? Let's align and reassess why you were doing what it is you were claiming you wanted to do. Because if it's something that you're serious about, if it's something that you really have intentions on doing, there's nothing that will stop you. So one, I evaluated where I was coming from in regards to why I chose to give up the fries for the month of October. And then I also evaluated, what's my reasoning for doing it? Is it strong enough, and is it a valid enough reason for me to do this? Because when I say I'm going to do something, I do it. Hello, it's 7 days and I've been in the gym every day working out, outside of working out other people. I've been working out myself because I'm so committed to what this brings about health-wise. And I've come to realize that when it's health-related and it's really truly something that's going to enhance my abilities of being the healthiest, like how physical exercise does, like how my nutritional resets do, there's no compromising there. There is no negotiations there. There is no yikes moments for me. I do it because of my why that's connected to it. So it may seem frivolous to you when I say I've given up fries, but that's a big deal for me. When I say I'm going to commit to something and I fail on whatever I've attempted to do, that's a big deal to me. So I want to share that with you guys openly and candidly, because I want you to understand that this lifestyle is a journey. This lifestyle of healthy living is one that we all can embrace. And if there's days and months or whatever that goes about and you're making choices that don't necessarily work for you, then let's have a conversation about how we can reassess and reevaluate and realign you with what will actually work for you. So I wanted to share that with you guys. I love to come out and be candidly honest. So now moving forward this week, I have a new drive. I have a new goal. And it's still going to be, I'm not having fries. And I'm going to keep going with that initiative. Because for me, it's consciously keeping me aware of my food choices. Not something that's quick and easy, that's on the go. Something that's going to nutritionally satisfy me and my body, that's going to support all the other nutritional things that I do on a daily basis. I need to fuel myself. I deserve to fuel myself in a way that's going to leave me feeling good. Feeling good inside and feeling good here. Not beating myself up for choices. So what did you put here? I desire to get into God's word. Yes, dear. I love him so much, but I desire to study and dive into his word. Yes. Diving into the word of the Spirit is one true surefire way to get you connected with your goals in life. The things that you want and the things that God wants for you can come into alignment, but it's all about being connected. And it's also about having that body in a place to where it can receive the word as it's coming in. Because if we are healthier, we can receive healthy messages, not head junk, not head fog. Yes, let's get healthy. Yes, quick and easy, right? So meal prepping is really important, but sometimes you'll meal prep and you still will say, well, I'll do that. I'll eat that tomorrow. Or when you're eating it, you feel sometimes like you're just doing something to do when you're meal prepping and you're really not connected with the meal itself. I want people to be connected with their meals, not just shoveling something in their mouths just to stay satiated. I want you to prep the meals that are healthy for you, but that are also enjoyable and tasty. So that's a way to be conscious of keeping with this lifestyle, because meal prepping gets boring. Meal prepping can be daunting. Meal prepping can be overwhelming. Meal prepping can be all of those things if we're prepping meals that we don't want. There's healthy meals that you can have that you do want, and those are the meals that I encourage you to start prepping for. So it's beyond just a healthy meal prepping. It's some other mindset pieces that go along with that. So this message, I'm loving engaging me as we're talking live, because this allows for me to kind of tap into where your head is and maybe assist you in some type of way, because that's what I'm passionate about, guys. If you don't know anything else about Amira, if you don't know anything else about me, this is what I love to do. I love people to be healthy mind, body, and soul. And so if I can help with that in any kind of way, if my lifestyle and the things that I do and sometimes the mishaps that I have will assist you, then I will continue to be as honest as I can with you guys. So it's time for me to get in action. We have a new week ahead. This week is a little different. Last week I was coming more in the evenings. It was really coming as I could. Whatever time I could fit into my schedule is when I came to work out. And that's what I want you guys to do, flexible and fluid. Making sure that you're gonna be doing it. Making sure that you're accepting of your schedule and working through it. Like I said, the fluidity of it. And just being flexible of your times and all of that great stuff. So I may be coming more in the mornings versus in the evenings, but we'll see. Whatever it is, just know you'll see me every day. In the gym, whether it's just gym or another gym that I visit, I will be coming to get my fitness on, boo-boos. My fitness on. Bye, guys. Love you.